Hello, my name is Alex and welcome to TechFlow. As you guys know, I have done countless networking videos on this channel, much because I absolutely love networking. I've done videos on how to get incredible Wi-Fi, I've done videos about access points, I've done videos about overpowered home networks, my home networks. The recurring question I always get though is, Alex, how can I get an insane Wi-Fi performance around my house and have an insane network, but without running loads of cables, access points, having a massive server rack? Not many people can do this, and I understand that. So, Developer have sent out their Magic 2 Powerline Wi-Fi adapter kit. Now, this uses Powerline technology and Wi-Fi meshing to make sure, well, apparently, you have an incredible connection around the house. Like usual, guys, here on TechFlow, we're going to give you our verdict on this product. Let's unbox it, let's test it, let's do this. But first, let's thank our sponsor. Thanks to Amazon Play & Shop for sponsoring today's video. It's going to allow you to earn credit back every in-game and app purchase that you make whilst you play on your Android device. So guys, what I'm going to go ahead and do is, well, first off, take this thing out of the box so we can test it out. But my main goal with this is going to be to run a test over my local network connected to one of these Wi-Fi adapters to see what actual theoretical speeds we get, because obviously I only get about 100 meg to my house of actual TCP/IP internet. So a lot of you guys might get 300 to 1,000 meg if you're lucky enough to have something like Google Fiber. So I'll do a sort of like an iPerf test around the house with these just to see what theoretical speeds I can get to a wireless device. But essentially, I believe this is the master unit. I'm learning this along with you guys and we will eventually test it. But there you go, lovely big master unit, I suppose. It has a pass-through port here, so you can plug it in and then plug something else into it. Included is a gigabit patch cable, so I assume the ports are gigabit, and then you get two of the actual meshing adapters. Now, as I've told you guys, these actually use a Wi-Fi mesh to connect to each other as well as power lines, so you sort of get the best of both worlds. What I've gone ahead and done, guys, is unplugged my two wired access points in this house. So this is actually a perfect test because we've got two access points with this Developer kit. I've got two wired access points in this house. I've unplugged them, so this is a fair test. So the only Wi-Fi that's going to be running is what's going to be coming from these Developers. What I'm going to go ahead and do is plug this into the, should we call it the master adapter, and then plug this in sort of the center of the house. So now this has a wired Ethernet connection up to one of my switches, which actually has a fiber backhaul 10 gigabit to the main switch up in the loft. And then, fun fact for all you Wi-Fi geeks, Wi-Fi actually falls down. The signal falls with gravity. It makes sense if you think about it. So if you have your Wi-Fi access points upstairs, you're gonna get better overall coverage than having them sort of on the bottom floor when you're upstairs. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is plug one of these over here. So we're going to go ahead, guys, and plug one of them in here. So this should cover these two rooms and the kitchen downstairs. And then as this is an L-shaped house, I'm going to go and time-lapse through here and plug one in through here. And then this is my, well, master bedroom, my room. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this in here. This should cover all of this end of the house and then the lounge downstairs. Like I say, I don't know how these really work, as it says in the box. Magic, apparently. Hopefully I can try and figure it out in this video for all of us. But I don't know how they're going to mesh together. I don't know if this meshes back to the main unit and uses power line at the same time, or this will mesh with the other Wi-Fi unit that's the other end of the house. That would be a little bit stupid because it's quite far away. Not sure how this works. Let's go and figure it out while they're hopefully automatically configuring themselves. Right, so guys, I've been having an absolute mare with this, and that's because of advertising. So let me read all of you this, because I don't think it's just me that's been mistaken here. So it says, invisible forces are at work. It says, novel mesh Wi-Fi and innovative power line technology links all Developer Magic adapters to an associated network so you can get seamlessly on the internet anywhere in the home with the strongest connection. Now, that to me reads that between all of the adapters, you've got Powerline technology transferring the data as well as Wi-Fi mesh. But I've read through the entire small instruction manual, which essentially says, write down the code on the back of it, the Wi-Fi code, which annoyingly is different on each unit on the back of here, and then it just works, apparently, that's it. And if you want to copy the same SSID as your router or router, it has a WPS button on it, but there's nowhere in anywhere in here that says that they are wirelessly meshing together. Maybe they are, maybe it's just Powerline. I don't know. I don't know. So guys, massive props to Dovolo on the app side of things. I downloaded the app and within seconds of clicking on it, it had found all three of the adapters. So as you guys can see here, my phone screen, at the top we've got the internet connection, then we've got the adapter that we plugged into the main switch, and then we've got our two adapters here. Now you can go into these and configure them yourself instead of using WPS, but there's nowhere in here that's saying that they are meshing together and the signal quality of that mesh or anything. I think it's just clever marketing to say that if you just change the Wi-Fi name to the exact same on both the Dovolo adapters that you can roam around your house. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. You have an option up here to have it on 2.4 or 5 gigahertz, but for this test, I'm just gonna use 5 gigahertz and I'm just gonna take this and put in TechFlow. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do is do the exact same thing to the other one, set the SSID to TechFlow and the password to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and put it in the 5 gigahertz only mode for this, just because we wanna test the theoretical speeds, and 5 gigahertz is the best network to do that on. So as you guys can see here, we've got both of our LAN adapters. When I actually changed the SSID and password of this one, it changed it on this one as well. So as you can see, if I go in here, click on the settings, click on Wi-Fi, as you can see, it changed it on both of them, which is awesome. So technically now, if I go into my Wi-Fi here, there should be a network called TechFlow. So guys, I'm connected to our new TechFlow network, an SSID that's being broadcasted by our two Dovolo Wi-Fi adapters. I'm gonna use an app here, as you guys can see my phone screen, called Wi-Fi Sweet Spots. What this is gonna do is measure the internet speed purely between this device and the access point. So what we're looking for here is for the speed to decrease as we walk from the access point, this end of the house, which is literally just above this table, into the lounge, and hopefully it will bang back up to speed once it reconnects to the access point, which is in my bedroom above the lounge. So let's click start, and as you guys can see, 684 meg, 695, slowly going up, capping out at around 700 meg. That's pretty respectable for wireless AC for the home use. So let's get up. As you guys will see when I walk around, you'll see this decrease a little bit. That's absolutely fine. As long as it doesn't drop below sort of 200. You're laughing and joking, really. But as you can see, as I walk through here, it is gonna decrease until, hopefully, it then connects through. There we go, bang. You guys just seen it on the screen, 793. You see that line there? So it's connected to our other access point. That proves that our mesh network is working successfully and roaming around the house should be a breeze. Brilliant. So guys, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is put the phone away. We don't need that anymore. And let's do some more testing. So I've got a MacBook here and I've actually got my server that's up in a loft. Now what I'm gonna go ahead and do is unplug this Ethernet cable, which is going into the magic LAN adapter to give both of our WLAN adapters internet connection. Let's unplug that. What I'm gonna do is plug it into my laptop here and download a movie off my server up in the loft to get some base testing, to see what the speeds are like to my server over an Ethernet cable. Then we'll move on to testing it over the Wi-Fi. So guys, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just get info on this 21 Jump Street folder. As you can see, it's 1.61 gig up in my server in the loft. So what I'm gonna do is drag this onto the desktop and do a stopwatch at the same time. 3, 2, 1, and they're off. Okay, so we're transferring. Done. 15.59 seconds over wired Ethernet. Let's try it on the LAN adapters. So again guys, same thing again, I'm gonna drag the exact same folder from my server, only difference is we are now connected to our TechFlow network being broadcasted by the Dovolo WLAN adapters. If you guys look on my screen up here, as you can see it says 0 kilobytes, this is a handy little network tool that I've got to see actual transfer speeds. So, 3, 2, 1, bang. So as you guys can see here on my screen, we're downloading at around 60 megabits a second. We're maxing out about 65 as the fastest I have seen. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not amazing. They do the job. 60 meg is okay for pretty much anything, to be honest. You wouldn't really notice a hitch, but... Right, guys, it's still copying over a couple of minutes later. What I have figured out from this is that if you have less than 60 meg coming into your house, you're going to get the full network capacity through these adapters, but they seem to be maxing out around 61 to 65 megabits per second, which again is perfectly reasonable for Wi-Fi. The brilliant takeaway from all this though is that I'm getting this 62 meg wherever I am, which is absolutely brilliant. 62, 64, 60, 65, 65 still, 64 still, 64 still, 64 still, 62. Everywhere I go, I'm getting the full capacity. I've just hit 68, actually. So that is that, guys. These are the Dovolo Magic 2 adapters. I mean, take them as for what they are. It's been a little bit of clever advertising that really got me hooked. And we're pulling around 60 meg. For any constellation, this is a brand new house. So the wiring is good. If it's an older house, results may vary. But there you go, 60 meg all over my house. Take it for what it is. I'll show you guys the numbers and you can judge yourself. So as you guys can see on here, it says on here that we've got theoretical transfer speeds of 2,400, 1,200. It's all a bit iffy. The top and bottom of it is I got about 60 megs worth of real throughput through these adapters, through the Powerline network in the house, which, you know what? It's acceptable. So that's all that these magic adapters guys have to offer. But for now, we need to thank our sponsor. This video is sponsored by Play In Shop by the Amazon App Store for Android. You actually earn credit back whilst you play on your Android device. All you lot have got to do is go to the link in the description, download the Amazon App Store and enroll in Play In Shop. Once you are enrolled onto the program, any purchase that you guys make in games will give you 10% back in Amazon credit. So if you're spending money, let's say in Candy Crush or Minecraft, you may as well be earning credit back that you can spend on Amazon. The credit accumulates and can be spent on Amazon, and you can buy, well, anything. Electronics, books, games. Perfect time for some savings this Christmas. But guys, thanks for watching today's TechFlow video. Really do hope you've enjoyed it. If you guys want to see some other networking videos, there's two right there for your eyes to feast on. And if you're not subscribed to our channel, we'd really appreciate that. And if you are, well, drop a like, because we'd appreciate that too.